Luke, looking at the 7-5 record and what you guys have done through the first 12 games, what are your thoughts on the progress that the team has made?
I'm happy with the progress. We just can't be satisfied with where we're at. We got a very tough stretch coming up. There's going to be some ups and downs, and we got to continue to just come in and work and continue to trust in what we're doing, whether we win games or lose games, and keep working on getting better as a team and what we're trying to do.
In what areas do you think the biggest improvements need to be made?
It's been the same all year. It's been keeping teams off the free throw line. It's been turnovers. There is progress on the defensive end. There's progress in the way we're playing on the offensive end. But we make it really hard on ourselves when we send teams to the line as much as we've been doing, and we turn the ball over and don't get back on defense.
It seems like JC's been really effective on pull-up jumpers. Is he getting better at recognizing what defenses are giving him?
I think so. He's been great. And he plays with that second unit that, they play a little faster, and there's a little more spacing out there, and he's done a great job of attacking bigs and pulling up, and when they're up higher on him, using his quickness to get around him and finish around the rim. He's been good at it.
What's the biggest challenge with facing San Antonio?
They're, in my opinion, they're the most most professional team there is in this league. And I told the guys today, any wasted possessions against them, they just they chew that up with their defense. If we don't know what play we're in, or we're not executing, cutting hard, setting hard screens, they'll take full advantage of that. And they're going to continue on the other end. They're going to continue to to move the ball and run their plays and set hard screens. So whether we get up, on them, or we get down on them, they're just going to keep playing the same way. And it's impressive that they can do it every single night, no matter who their opponent is. It's a great challenge for us.
You've seen a lot of Popovich over the years. What stands out most to you in terms of why he's so successful?
He gets his players to play hard and play the right way. And it's not, there's so many breakdowns in the NBA with how long the season is. And that have the run that they've had over there, and to still continue to do the little things and not get satisfied and slip with the setting of the screens and the backdoor cutting and all those things that are naturally what teams slip on when they've had success, his teams don't. And that just means that he does a heck of a job coaching them.
Did you ever have the chance to cross paths with Pop or pick his brain about anything?
No, I walked to the coaches' meetings with him this year in Chicago one morning. That was nice, but I never really had a chance to pick his brain. Just heard lots of stories from Steve Kerr over the last 2 years about how great he is.
You had mentioned after the last game that you think Brandon Ingram can be a lockdown defender, pretty close to it. We'd just talked to him, and he had said he had never really thought he could be that, that he didn't really focus on that. Did you know that coming in, that he wasn't really focusing on defense?
No, we wouldn't have drafted him if I knew that. I was not aware of that, but he's a good defender. He's got a good feel for where cutters are coming from and how to use his length. And if he puts his mind to it, in practice, in the games, down, towards the end of games when it gets tight, and he really locks in on defense, he's tough to score on.
What is he learning about
how
to use that wingspan?
A lot of this league is about angles, and like the block he had in that last game in Brooklyn at the end of the game. He took the body contact, but he wasn't trying to fight it to where it knocked him off balance. He let the guy make his move and was able to use his wingspan to still be there to block that shot. The best defenders that have those wingspans, Andre was the same way up in Golden State. He would gap his man and then use that length to contest shots and make them take hard shots. And you learn to live with guys that make a couple of those, but overall you feel like you give your team a better chance if those are the type of buckets they're scoring.
How rare is it for such a young guy at the, you know, this age to be to have that understanding of those angles?
It's very rare. I'm not saying he has them down yet. I'm saying he's getting better at them.
At least be able to see
and,
the things he sees.
And he'll be great at it once he, fully understands it and fully commits to it. He'll be great at it. But to play defense anyway at this level at his age is near impossible. I mean, these are grown men you're playing against, and it's normally physically just beats you down. But he's been pretty good with it.
Who do you think is the best defender on this team right now?
It changes because we're trying to build our identity as a good defensive team, so we're getting good effort from people. But the effort's the effort's not inconsistent. The execution of it is a little inconsistent. So some nights it's JC, other nights it's been Nick. Julius, when he wants to be, he's a monster pressuring the ball. Timo's done a great job protecting the paint. So it kind of just like our offense from game to game changes who's got the hot hand. The defensive role has been changing as well.